everybody to another episode of Skate Line NBD, and Griffin is gassed up 91 premium octane. Now, a name that you don't really know, but you might have heard on accident if you skateboard, is Nick Palmquist. He decided that it would be a bright idea, I'm talking Colgate Smile White bright idea, to go tray flip on the top of the pyramids. And when he got to the bottom, the police beat him like Ike did Tina for missing any note on any song he ever wrote ever. What'd you think was gonna happen? It's the Middle East. The gold is gone. Niggas done came and dug the shit up, took all the fucking mummies, two chains, got it around his neck and shit. They ain't got shit left. Of course they whooped his ass. Nigga, you rode there on Camelback. You took a Camel Uber to your ass whooping. Troy Pudwell comes through with his firing line, or his version of it, because I could have sworn it was supposed to be one miraculous line. Bow! One shot. Not two, what a magic bullet. I know you wanted to break this off with the 2-for-1 special, but this ain't Great Value or Grocery Outlet, nigga. I need one good item of, it's free anyway. You weren't helping nobody. This week's damn nigga, the world's first ever colossal spin. Not that he went above coping, it's that he was big, wild, big spinning ghost to Jamie Foy. This is like street vert gangster status. What is going on? Provis drops an edit for his company Sockadelic, which I'm pretty sure is his because he put a P in front of sock. Kinda like we do for pterodactyl. We don't need it, it's just there. Just to fuck up the English language and to make a few kids fail the spelling test, so who's gonna join the spelling bee? Teacher look at you, spell pterodactyl. Start with a T, immediately can't join the team, Gary. Go to the back of class. Also change your card, I'll be calling your mother soon. I told you how to spell pterodactyl, you fucking idiot. My bad, that's my personal shit. I'm working on it with y'all, this is therapy. What I did catch is this dude rolling across with a wheel on the bottom. Talk about missing the point. I feel like if Jesus had a wheel on the bottom of the cross, he wouldn't have came back for nigga sins. He would have just left it alone. Like, I walked up here easy, nigga. This was nothing. It dragged through dirt, hit bumps, nothing. My shoulder was good. I just walked up here and they killed me slow. When you go to Grant Taylor's 20th anniversary party and he could sip his beer, watch you skate, and say, I'm good off joining the edit, you have to beat Milton Martinez. Get it. Hello? Fully the world's longest transitional nose blunt ever. Give him something. He didn't get sody. He over riding on doors, lip slide, construction sites. No Martinez has been a problem all year. Get this. Step in and do your job. For I do it for you. I don't have a book. What type of foreign sweet talking shit went on here? Vans is sponsoring a thing called Sleeping Nowhere when nothing happens? Like, no, literally, what happened here? What is going on in this video? It doesn't cost shit to sleep outside, so why does somebody need to promote that? I know a crackhead outside right now. If I told the Vans was paying niggas to do this, he'd be like, what? I can get checked for this? It's crazy. Tyshawn Jones is one sody and skateboarders lost their damn mind. They don't know what's going on. Why did he win? He only gave us one trash can part. If you would have seen that Supreme blessed part, y'all would know quickly, but Supreme must be holding that shit for ransom. Beyonce is wearing y'all clothes. I know somewhere in the budget you can give this up for free. Everybody, dead niggas. You seen that casket with the Supreme logo on it? Everybody got y'all shit. Give us the part. This is good night from another episode of Skate Line NBD, and Bill Wester, enjoy your hairline while it lasts. Another episode of Skate Line NBD has been wrapped in the foil like a grande carne asada burrito with no guacamole, extra cheese, nigga, two links.